Happy holidays, everybody. This is Gabriel John Coombs here once again, and it's time for Mega Man 4. AD200X. Household robots rock and roll were created by master robot designer Dr. Light, and they were enjoying their very peaceful days. Then one day, the industrial robots all over the world went on a rampage, and the world fell into total chaos. Dr. Light quickly realized that mad scientist Dr. Wowie was behind the nefarious deed, but he didn't know what to do. Rock, or well, Mega Man, if I guess you say Mega Man. So let's go with Mega. Mega, having a strong sense of justice, volunteered to be converted into a fighting robot. Thus, the super robot Mega Man, or Rockman in Japanese, was born. Takes him a while to open his eyes. Mega Man shattered Dr. Wowie's plans 3 times, and world peace has been maintained so far. But history repeats itself. Dr. Cossack, a mysterious scientist, has invented 8 powerful robots and sent them after Mega Man. Mega Man starts for the battle again, this time equipped with the powerful new Mega Buster. Yeah, that means we can finally charge. It's about time, after 3 games, we can finally charge. Anyway, Mega Man 4. I am so excited for this. I have been waiting. After doing a full year of Mega Man the Wily Wars, I really want to get started on this. Let's do it. So, we have 8 all-new Robot Masters. And going in alphabetical order, Bright Man is first. Bright Man is hard. His stage is hard. Oh, just to say something on a side note, I'm definitely going to be abusing the Turbo Controller now for the next little while, because Turbo Controller is fun. Yeah, I'm abusing Turbo Controls. Turbo Controls are fun. Turbo Controls, really help against these Tiki guys here. And they also help against this guy. Man, I love the Tiki. I don't love the Tikis. I meant to say Turbo, not Tiki. What am I talking about? As you can tell, I'm really, really excited. What better way to start off the holiday season than Mega Man 4, hey? Okay, for these platforms, you have to jump as soon as they stop. Like now. If you jump as soon as it stops on one side, then you'll jump a lot higher, and that will come in handy a couple rooms later. Alright. So, here we go. More cricket crossing, as I like to call it. All right. So, we can ignore that enemy there, and we can ignore the weapon energy, considering we don't have any special weapons yet. Okay, whatever you do, don't shoot this guy. He will darken the area, and there's no firework guys to light up the place. So do not shoot them, whatever you do. Alright, halfway there, let's do this. Alright, and we're at Brightman. Yeah, you're definitely going to need that 1E tank for Brightman. See, poor Brightman here has a very nasty habit of jumping into you. I could beat this guy with just the Mega Buster. I wish I had his weakness, but hey, I'm doing this in alphabetical order. It makes it so much harder. And another thing I hate is the Flash Stopper. The Flash Stopper is so incredibly annoying. There. Goodbye, Bright Man. You're just like Woodman and Quickman, spawns of Satan. Anyway, so we get our first power. What a flashy new weapon screen. You got the Flash Stopper. And it makes us turn pink. Oh no. The deadly color of pink. Alright. So, I'm going to save. Once I find save. There. Okay. So, sorry for that. I'll make sure that's fixed by the next video. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. And I will see you all next time for when we go off against Dive Man. So until then, this is Gabriel John Coombs saying adios, amigos.